and pray once, the door will open. And you will be praying and praying, and the door will not open. Because it's a level of authority given by God. Every handcuffs that have been released in the realm of the Spirit. This morning, lift up your hands for me. I pray that God will keep touching my heart, that I will continue to have mercy. Amen.
Amen.
You know the reason why I say that? I say, I pray that God will continue to touch my heart, that I will continue to have mercy. Because there are certain things that you go through, that God give me the authorization. God will automatically give me the authorization to stop it. If you have a man of God who don't have mercy, he won't stop it, and God cannot do anything about it. Are you understanding me? That is why God needed Eli to direct Samuel. Because the Bible said, and Samuel heard and came to Eli and said, did you call me? And Eli said, I didn't call you. And Samuel went back to bed. And the Bible said, he heard the voice the second time. And he came back to Eli and said, did you call me? And Eli said, I did not call you. But Eli knew that the voice was the voice of God. But Samuel did not know. So if Eli did not have mercy, Eli would tell him, go to bed. And Samuel will miss his blessing. And you can't do anything about it. But I cancel it. I cancel it. By the authority given to me by God. By the power given to me by God. I cancel it. I cancel it. Now, I cancel it. By the power of God. Father, I don't cancel it physically, but in the realm of the spirit, Father, I stand in the gap as a man of the house of the Lord. I cancel it now. I cancel it with the authority given to me by God. I cancel it in the name of Elohim, my God. I cancel it now. I cancel it. Father, the handcuffs, I release the fire of God and I burn it. I burn the handcuffs now. I release the blood of Jesus. I burn it, Lord. Father, when they locate it, it will be the wrong address, oh Lord. Father, when they locate her, it will be the wrong address. In the mighty name of Jesus. Now. Now, now, now. Yes, my God. Yes, my God. Yes, my God. Father, release her. Father, any demon that has been assigned to her today, I release the fire of God and I bend them. I bend them. I bend them. I bend them from their feet. I bend them. Today is your last day. My God, my God, my God. Masuria bayabro kentiria basintoria. Rabayaba. Na! Masuria bayab. You that demon, hear me and hear me well, because I can see you now. Now release the fire of God on you. I bend you, I bend you, I bend you. If you are sitting down, somebody pray. I need you to pray now. Now I release it. I bend you now. Today is your last day. Get up, get out of it. Get up now. Get up, get up, get out of it. By the fire of God, get up, get up. I release fire into it now. Now. Now get out of it. Get out. Get out. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. I'm not down with that. Friend down here. But amen. Friend, I will continue to do that. Demon. I've seen that demon. I'm tired with that. With that demon. That demon is a very ugly demon. Ugly fianga. Have you seen ugly fianga demon before? You know what is ugly fianga demon? The demons that will move, they won't carry, and they won't give anybody their way. They are ugly fianga demons. Amen. Somebody bow their head, let's pray. Father, let your word fall on a good ground this morning. Let your word fall on a good ground. Father, I pray and I take control in the realm of the spirit. Father, I pray and I take control now. Father, I take control from the realm of the spirit. Father, give me the entrance to speak, O Lord. Father, give me the power to operate this morning. Move my body aside and speak through me, God. Father, I block every demonic arrows released against my mind to disadvantage this day, O Lord. I scatter confusions, structures against me. I interrupt and overwrite every demon influence against everybody's mind. I release the mind to take like Christ and to decree the steps to overtake this morning. Father, I give you control. You are God. Do what you want to do. In the mighty name of Jesus. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen.
This morning, I am still continuing my message. And title is prophecy. This morning, we're going to... First one, what did we start with the first one? The first one was what?
Battle
of the mind. The second one is this one. I don't want to ask anyone to explain it. So that some people will go and take Chicago and all that. The second one was renew of what? Your mind. This morning is to take charge of your mind. Amen. Somebody say take charge.
Take charge.
Oh, I can't hear you. Somebody say take charge,
take charge
of your mind.
Your mind.
Mr. Woody, every English you want to change it. You don't know. Take charge.
Take charge
of your mind. Amen.
Amen.
Last Friday I explained something. It's a message that one of these Sunday I'll preach for everyone to understand. And it's about thrones. It's about throne. I explained and I shared. And see, on this side of the world, we don't see the thrones. We don't see them. When you go to different parts of the world, you see them, like where I come from. You see them. The sculpture is there. Amen. And sometimes you see some things around it. Amen. But on this part of the world, we don't see them like that. What they have done on this part of the world is they have made it so beautiful and so good. So we don't see it. You see, a throne is something that controls your will. A throne is something that controls your movement. It tells you what to do. Amen. So where I came from, you have the option to see the things sitting there. Amen. But at this on this part of the world, they have changed it and they've made it so beautiful that it is controlling us, but we don't see it. Are you here with me, somebody? On this part of the world, like I gave an example, listen. A strip club will be somebody's throne. If they don't go there, they won't sleep. They will sell everything they have to go there. And they will still not feel what? Satisfied. Are you there with me? Like I said, here they've made it so nice that they will tell you that, listen, we're going to give you somewhere to stay. We're going to give you the card. We're going to put cash on the card. Swipe it anytime you want. Feel good. Amen.
Amen.
They've made it so nice over here. But at the end of the day, they control your will. And they tell you what to do. Anything that controls you, it becomes a throne in your life. But here we worship them so beautifully because we've dressed them so nice. Like I will always say, back where I come from, they put on shoes. So when they come, you can hear them crocha, crocha, crocha. You know what's crocha? Their shoes crocha. Yeah, I know. Since I came to America, I didn't listen talking. And they are talking over here. They have it. Talking in my country. Good, good, good. You are in spirit. Listen, in my country, they have this thing. When what is like, go there. Everybody will be checking you out, you know? Yeah, because. What is this? Gocha, that is all greedy. The greed is gocha. It's all gocha. Good, good, good. You are in spirit. Don't listen to me. Amen. But here, on this part of the world, they are all putting on kambu.
Sneakers.
So when they are coming, we don't hear them. We don't see them. And we've dressed them so well, and we are feeling good in it. But I'm telling you, there is somebody there right now that is going through some big financial problem, and it has become a thorn in their life. They can't stop shopping. They are shopping so much, and they think it's normal. It is not normal. It is a thorn in your life. And if you don't take him out by the root, it controls your will.
Amen.
Anything that you don't control, and the thing controls you, it means that the thing is a throne in your life. But like I said, this part of the world, it is so nice, so we don't feel it. Back home, you will feel it. Sometimes in your bones, you are going to feel it. But here, they've made it so nice, so you are shopping, and you don't know how to stop. And the bills come, and you cannot be paying them. And you are going through a whole lot of drama. It is a throne, and if you don't deal with it, it will control your life. Do you know that some of us, we messed up our credit so much that, and now we need it so bad, and we can't get it. You know that? Now you are at a point in your life that, God, I need the credit now. But when you go to the store, like you go to Macy's and they put your social security number in the computer, the lady will look at you like, hey, you better leave or I call security. Because your social security number, the things he brought out, you better leave home. Now, are you understanding me? You've made this up so much that now that you need it, you can't get it. Back in the day, because no one told you about it, you were blowing it. Now that you can't take care of it, that thing has become a throne. And it will sit there. You see, if we're back in the other world, it will sit there and you will worship it. But because this side, they've made it so nice, you are feeling good around it. That's what we are doing. Listen, there's a whole lot of things that everyone is going through that we are feeling so good about it, that we don't know that it's a throne, because on this side, it is a normal thing to act to do. Some of them are demonic thrones. And if you don't deal with them, they will deal with you. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
It's a message that I'm still putting it together. Why do you think God, Jesus told Gideon, he said, go to your father's house and destroy the thrones in there. And after you finish destroying it, the thing will be. Listen, there are some things that we are going through, me and you, we are going through now. If we don't stop them now, they will climb up with you. And the day that you need to grow, it will give you problem. There are some things now in our lives, if we don't stop them and deal with them, I'm talking about spiritual things. Listen, there are some certain things in everybody's life now. If you don't stop them, if you don't deal with them by fire, if you don't find time, fasting, prayer, breaking that thing, I said you are climbing and the thing will climb with you. And when you get to the top, it will start giving you problems.
Isn't so weird that yesterday I was telling Prince that you heard that a man of God have gone into the hotel with a woman, and it's not an ordinary man of God, you know, be a great man of God. Why do you think that happened? Come on, just think about it for a minute. Why would a big man of God, maybe on TV, you know, Everyone know who you are. Why would you go to that level? You think it's normal? You know, you think it's controlled by his own mind. If it's controlled by his own mind, you think he will do it. Anytime you see that, listen, when the devil is about to expose a church member, he used the silent pistol. But when it comes to pastors, he will use bazooka. So that everyone will what? Hear it. Because let me tell you, we can close from church now. And you can go to your boyfriend's house. You can chill. I will call you on the phone. You are like, Pastor, I'm praying right now. So I will call you when I'm done. Because you are playing Abiwaha. You don't want me to hear it. So the pastor, I'm in spirit now. And my level, I can't talk right now. But when I leave, I will call you. But the level that you are, it's only God who knows the level that you are. Are you here with me?
Yes.
But let the pastor, after church, go to somebody's house, not by permission. You will see what will happen. You people are laughing. You know what I'm talking about. Amen. So I need everyone in this room today. You have a throne to deal with. Everyone's throne will be different. What I need you to understand is, if we don't deal with certain thrones in our lives today, in life, once you are with God, once the Bible says the thought that I have for you, it's not of evil, it's of good. And once you are with God, gradually God will move you up, one after the other. One after the other, God will move you. God will keep moving you. And it will come to a time that the way you were feeling back then, that God, why is this thing keep going on? It will come to a time that those things will stop. Because prayer is like fire. And wherever there is fire, the enemy can't stand there. So it will come to a time that things will turn around in your life for your good. But I need you to understand, if those things turn around, there are some of them, if we don't deal with them right now, they will climb with us, and we will get to a top that when we are about to grow, they will deal with us. You will see. I'm telling you. There are some of them, if we don't deal with them now, they will go with us to the top, and they will stay there with us. Because sometimes when I should say, why will a great man of God go into a hotel with another woman? And everyone know you. Do you think it's normal? That is a high-level demon. I mean, because when you think of, no man of God in his right sense will do that. It means that something that he did not deal with from his past had followed him to his level. And don't tell me that God is going to come and deal with it. God has already finished doing everything already. You have to deal with it. That is why I tell you, when you are praying, if they say, God, come and do this, say, by the power given to me by God, I deal with it. Because when you say, God, come and do it, God is not coming. God, he won't come. He has already given the power to you. Amen. To you. Amen. Everyone in here has the power given to him by God. If you don't use it, don't blame God. Why are you people looking at me like that? Amen.
Amen.
I want to talk about take charge of your mind. The book of Philippians. Philippians 4:8. Isaac, you're welcome. Please come and play me a song. Please. Since you are here, let me go to some levels. You know? Philippians 4:8. If you are there, say amen.
Amen.
If you are not there, say amen.
Amen.
If the Bible is not for you, say amen. You are saying the truth, so that's... Oh no, take it. That is it. Put it down. Now, these things are things to make you release yourself. You understand? Don't want you to be too stiff. You know, we're in the house of God. Amen.
Amen.
Listen. Your mind, listen to this. Your mind is what drives your destiny. Listen to this carefully. Your mind is the vehicle that drives your destiny.
So whatever you think today, that is what you're going to get tomorrow. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Are you here with me?
Yes.
Your mind is the vehicle that drives your destiny. So if you are praying that God, let me tell you one thing. Go past that, it's not here. So you see, I prayed some prayer. I said, God, give me a wife with long hair. I prayed that prayer.
You did?
I did.
Ah.
No joke. Because I like women with long hair. So I don't know. Listen, I don't want to get married and now I see another woman with long hair and I'm looking. So I say, God, give me a wife with what? Long hair. So now when I see you with long hair, I don't worry anymore. Because I'm already booked up.
Yeah.
No, you understand? These are the prayers. You people think it's a joke, eh? I pray this kind of prayer because I don't want drama. I don't want any problem. So those of you who are praying for big tall guys like me, you better keep praying. Because whatever you pray today is what God will want, will give you. If you pray that let me go broke, you are going to go broke. If you pray that God bless me, God will bless you. So the things you say out of you, it is what you will become. So you got to be careful the things you say, because your mind will tell you what to say, and the things your mind tell you to say is what is going to drive your life. Please read for me. Who's reading for me?
Philippians chapter 4. Bible says, finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are.
Because listen to the topic. It said, take what? Take charge of your mind. We started from the mind was a battleground. So every time you wake up in the morning, it's a battle for you. Amen. So if you know your battles, after that, you got to go back and do what? Renew your mind. Now, when you start renewing your mind, you got to do what?
Take charge.
You got to take charge of it. It means that you are in control. If you don't take charge of your mind, the devil will control your mind. I said, if you don't take charge of your mind, the enemy will control your mind. And when the enemy controls your mind, he tells you what to do. Anyone that controls your mind drives where you are going. That is why those of you who are kids, right? Your daughter or your son will feel comfortable to put their hand in your mouth. But they won't feel comfortable to put their hand in a stranger's mouth. Because they know you are their covering. And it will not be easy. You will not even think about it to bite them. But a stranger, they won't do it. Because they know that they don't know that person. But with you, they know that you are their covering. So if you don't take charge of your mind, I want you to understand something this morning, that the enemy will control your mind and he will tell you where to go.
Amen.
There are some things in your life that don't expect them to go away. Listen carefully. Everyone in this room, there are some things in your mind that you have to fight them every day of your life. Amen.
Amen.
Are you here with me?
Yes.
There are some things that, listen, and I'm telling you, this thing will come from your past, that it will control you so much that you're going to be like, Pastor, why is it that this one, I can't overcome it? It means that it's a day in and day out battle with that thing. Don't think that, listen, there are some things that you are going to go through that don't think that you wake up one morning and they will go away. They will never go away. You have to battle them. You wake up and say, God, this is what I keep going through. I can't stand this one no more. I let the fire of God tame this thing. With the fire of God, I control it. Then you move on. When the thing comes back to your mind, you say, God, this thing is coming back. I stop it with the blood of Jesus. Then you move on in life. You have to control them before you can move on. Because some of them, the devil will keep bringing them back to you. It's not going to go away. There are some of them, when you look at them, you're going to be like, you, I don't even want to see you. There are some of them, you got to deal with them. And God don't even look at you. Those of you, let me tell you, those of you who are always killing yourself with your past, please stop. Because God don't care about your past. Listen, if you are a child of God, God don't care about your past. The only thing God cares about is for you to move forward. The devil only cares about your past. That is why they call him the accuser of what? The brethren. But God don't care about what you have done in the past. All God wants to hear is, how are we going to move forward? How are we going to do this? How are we going to do that? That is why this morning I am here to let you understand that whatever you are going through, you got to look forward, because God is making sure that you are going to move forward. Whatever has happened in your past, a year ago, let it go. We don't care about it anymore. Because if you think about it, the devil used that to pull you back. But as a child of God, you don't care about the things in your past. All you care about is, God, how am I going to look good for the next guy who is coming into my life? How am I going to put on the best makeup for the next guy who can see me and say, "Ha, I like your makeup this morning. Can I have your number?" But if you keep looking at your past, every day for coming, he's going to keep pulling you back.
Hallelujah. Hey.
Some of you got to let it go. Leave it alone. Leave it alone. Let's move forward. Leave it alone. You are talking about your past too much. Let it go. Leave it alone. God don't want to hear it anymore. God, it comes to a time that God is tired with it. Listen, I don't want to hear it anymore. Let's move on. Some of you are killing yourself with your past. It's okay. You've done it and you feel good about it. So what? Let it go. Throw it away somewhere. Let's move on. Are you here with me, somebody? I need to inject this into somebody's hard drive this morning. And let it stay there. Let it be written on your skin as a tattoo. And let it stay there. That from today, I am done with my past and I don't want to hear it anymore. He said, God, this thing is keeping coming back to me. And it's my past and that shit. From today, I am done with it. Somebody lift up your right hand for me. Somebody lift up your, say, in the name of Jesus. Oh, I can hear you. In the name of Jesus. Anything from my past that the devil is using against me, this morning, by the blood of Jesus, I burn it